Hello and welcome to Boundary Busters, a show that's similar to, but legally distinct from, She Says' Boundary Break, where we take the camera to places it was never intended to go. Every time I've seen a video like this, it's always taken place in a video game. I've long wondered why nobody bothered to apply the same technique to archival footage, so I guess it'll have to be the change I want to see in the world. Please excuse how off the cuff this is. This is basically just my stream setup. Kind of just recorded myself playing around and then edit that down. That said, let's get started. The first specimen we're looking at is this clip from the Employees Only Museum at Nintendo of America, circa 2006. It's a neat watch with a lot of obvious stuff. Pikachus and Nintendos. But... pause. What on earth? Why is this tiny bed here? What is going on? And this instantly reveals an answer to my earlier question. Video games generate their level data from files in a fundamentally different way than videos do. Worse, videos are lossily encoded, so a ton of details get lost, and that gets way worse when you start noclipping through the video. Check out these chairs though. Funky. Can we see what's on those screens? Nope. Not enough data from the video. You can even kind of see through the screens. Not to mention whatever's going on with that arcade cabinet over there. Oh well. Still kind of cool though, right? It's a bit of a computational problem, really. If I were to seek forward in the video a bit... yeah, there you go. Now that's what I call an arcade cabinet. The chairs are garbage now though. I'm sure it'd work better if I had a better computer. I don't think you can hear it, but my GPU is super revved up right now. Footage size is also important. I was using a 720p video there. This one's a much shorter clip, but in 1080. The shorter clip means less data because, again, lossy compression, but the data I do have is a little bit cleaner. Kind of. But wait, what's that? YouTube? Why YouTube? Because this is the sponsored section. I don't usually take sponsors. I don't want to endorse something that I wouldn't use, but I'm on YouTube. You're on YouTube, presumably. I don't know if I'm removing this section for the Patreon cut or not. But yeah, YouTube is sponsoring this video. Specifically, they're running a deal where some selected viewers can get 2 months of YouTube Premium for free. I've got a link in the pinned comment below, and if you subscribe using that, I may get a commission from it. So, the way that ads work on this website is kind of funny. Advertisers are a middleman. They pay YouTube to get eyes on their ads, and then YouTube pays creators to put those ads in their video. YouTube Premium cuts out that middleman. You, the premium user, will see no ads and support the channel you like. Okay, admittedly, I don't put ads on my videos very often, but when I do, 10% of you never know, and instead just kick a portion of your premium subscription to me. I personally think it's a pretty elegant solution. I'm shocked it's not listed front and center on the YouTube Premium promo page. I guess it's because YouTube memberships are more potent if you want to support a specific creator. Anyway, thanks to literally Google for sponsoring this video. Go check the pinned comment about it. Okay, back to boundaries. A recurring issue with old footage is that it's both short and in 480p. That's just the standard from back in the day. Also, that usually gets super compressed. Look at this footage from E3 2009. I'm not saying I could count these pixels, but I could just about count these pixels. And so, when you try to noclip into something like this, it gets wonky fast. See, the data is here, but it's stored as a sort of perspective illusion, you know? Nobody's gonna bother noclipping through a video, so there's no reason to store everything. But then, when someone like me comes along, those cut corners are super obvious. But also, I think there's a real beauty to this. It's a type of glitch art. Like, soak it in. It does get worse when there are people in the frame. If the scene's moving, no problem, but if there are people in the scene, they turn into weird blurs. Again, it's a perspective illusion. So you gotta crop them out before turning on noclip. Of course, this means that the resulting footage has even fewer pixels to work with. Let's say we want to check out what's on that desk. it's easy to crop this guy out, but now we have small blurry footage. How surprised are you that it breaks apart when you get closer? What's on the screen, I wonder? Garbage. Oh well. Okay, full disclosure time. This is all smoke and mirrors. The reason people don't try to noclip through videos is because it's just not possible. It's fun though, right? Imagine living in a JPEG artifact world.